Welcome to the Awakening Podcast Network. Get ready for an inspiring audio from this cutting-edge voice. You can find more podcasts at awakeningpodcasts.com.
A reset of the prophetic movement is upon us. The second wave of prophets is rising in this hour. We stand at the edge of a new era in the prophetic. We're gathering the international prophetic community at the Global Prophetic Center, a hub for prophetic training, prophetic labs, summits, networks, and lighthouses. It's time for prophets to go deeper. It's time for seers to soar. It's time for prophetic voices to rise up and decree what says the Spirit of God with accuracy that causes the world to pay attention. The Global Prophetic Center offers proven prophetic systems and structures to equip you to walk worthy of your calling and to prophesy with precision, boldness, diplomacy, and wisdom. Get hands-on training and mentoring in a safe environment that breeds true prophetic community and learning. Receive impartation and activation. Sharpen your gift and avoid prophetic pitfalls. Get commissioned. Get networked. Get sent out with the word of the Lord in your mouth and the confidence to release it. Begin your journey today by applying at globalpropheticcenter.com.
Are you someone that loves to sing in private unto the Lord, like maybe in your shower, or maybe you're even a little bit self-conscious about that even? Well, I can relate to that. But today we've got an exciting subject that is going to release all of you into freedom to sing the scriptures. We have with us Julie Meyer. So excited. You're not only one of my most favorite prophetesses and worship leaders, but you're a good friend.
Yes.
And you have a brand new book out that's got a foreword by Heidi Baker, and it's called Singing the Scriptures and How All Believers Can Experience Breakthrough, Hope, and Healing. And so we're going to discuss this whole thing of singing the scriptures, because you are the queen of this. You do this all the time. You have mentoring programs on it and everything. So tell us just a little bit about the power. Like, why would we sing scriptures?
Well, I have sang scriptures forever because I came from Kansas City with Mike Bickle, and it's singing and praying the Bible. And I started doing workshops just to teach worship teams how to sing the word and make up melodies. And I started noticing that people began to come who were not singers, but they began to get incredible breakthrough, like a lifetime of not understanding that God loves them. Bam, they would get it.
Wow.
I mean, just from singing the Bible. And I started asking myself, gosh, this is not just for worshipers. This is a tool that we all need in our tool belt for breakthrough, for establishing proper mindsets,
right,
about how God feels and thinks about you. And I just started seeing incredible breakthrough in people because they began to sing.
You know what I find really interesting is the book of Psalms is a book of songs, really, isn't it?
Yeah.
And David and his musicians would sing them. But just think about this, is that David was a king after God's own heart, a man after God's own heart, but he carried authority. And it made me wonder, does his authority, his spiritual authority that he carried, that anointing in the Lord, did it get birthed out of singing? Because probably out in the field, looking after the sheep, he was singing.
That's where he cultivated his life in God. And it is said of David, when I did research, that David went to war with a sword in his hand and a song on his lips.
Wow.
And so I just began to ask, what is it about this? And I began to see, I just started reading lots of books. In fact, it's you can find them all over Amazon now, Singing in the Brain, The Power of Music in the Brain. It's everywhere. And they're using it for medical and scientific research. And what I found out, and this is so cool, is when we sing, It's one of the only things that we do where all of our brain, our lobes actually work together as one. So the left side of the brain is our talking right here. The right side is when you add a tone, you can even sing on the same note for people. And the rhythm is in the back when you add a little bit of rhythm. And the emotional response is right here.
Whoa.
So it's almost like when we sing, it creates this helmet so that the only thing that gets in us is the words that we're singing. So when we add singing the Bible, that onslaught of negativity, that comparison, everything that we're hit with in the world, it can't get in.
Well, I love
that.
The
only thing that can get in is what you are singing. And we know that the Word of God, it is alive and it is powerful. And they're actually using singing to reach Alzheimer's. They're using singing now to reboot stroke victims, to reboot their brain.
Wow.
They're actually finding out that when we sing, that it releases endorphins that actually help our mood. It's like working out for an hour, and they're using it with depression. It is a powerful tool that has always been with us, but I believe that the Lord is really bringing it back again.
Singing actually really does lift your spirit. Like even like if you're going through, let's say a circumstantial pressure or something that's difficult, if you just take time to just start singing, it could be just anything. It lifts your spirit. Mm-hmm. So if you take the Word and start singing it out, how much more powerful is that?
It really is. And Paul tells us in Colossians 3, let the Word of God dwell in you richly by teaching, admonishing, and he says by singing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs.
Yeah, I love that. Well, Jehoshaphat, he went out into war at the direction of the Lord. And all the praisers, the musicians, the singers were to go before, because it clears something in the spirit. It can clear whole atmosphere. So if it does that for an atmosphere to win a battle, how much more inside of us?
Because our battle is in the brain.
Yeah.
And I actually did an experiment for 2 years, and I didn't tell anyone. Because I started going, why does singing work? And anytime I was having a negative emotions about if I was frustrated or angry or fearful, I made myself sing. I made myself sing. And every single time that emotion that I was feeling was overpowered by singing the Bible. That is how strong of a tool singing is, and I like to say in the book, if you sing the Bible, it is not a guarantee that you will make the worship team, but it is a guarantee you'll get breakthrough.
Right.
Because my testimony is 100% breakthrough 100% of the time when you sing the Bible.
Wow. Well, a good question would be like, do you have to be a good singer to be able to sing the Bible?
No. No. And you know, like the Catholic Church has used this for years, even the Hebrew, that's just singing on one note, just sing. Because again, it's not about, you kind of have to push a little bit and get this, I've got to be a Sunday morning singer and sound beautiful. This is the tool of singing.
Right.
And so we're picking up the tool and when we sing again, I love the Lord because he hears my voice and my cry. That melody right there, that's what we're after. Or even on the very same note, because it's the tool behind the singing. We're like, we got to think a little bit differently. We're learning a new craft. We're learning a new skill on how to fight our personal and emotional battles.
Right.
And medical science is doing this right now.
Right.
So if they're doing it, we need to do it.
Because it started
it's, we got ahead first.
It started here. There's a song in our heart. I think a lot of times people feel a little bit self-conscious about singing, right? Because, you know, if you feel like you don't have a good voice and you're singing away, and also how do we get the tune to go with the words, you know, and it brings intimidation. I don't know. Is anyone else feeling that? I feel like that sometimes. But when we hear you sing, it's like, oh my gosh, yeah, Julie, she can sing the scriptures, but I don't think I better dare open my mouth. But that is not it, is it?
No. And number one, everyone sounds good in the shower. You just do. But it's not even about, oh, I've got to have this beautiful melody. It's just singing even on the very same note. That right there will give you breakthrough when you add the word of God to it, because your brain is working together. And also, they're finding out that when we sing, it activates parts of our brain that are never activated unless we sing. Therefore, I say bankers need to sing, entrepreneurs need to sing, because you actually will get more. And I want to erase the, I have to sound beautiful. We want Sunday morning and conferences to sound beautiful. This is about personal breakthrough. And you do have to push a little bit. Just do it in the car.
Right.
Just pick a note. Any note works.
And any scripture.
Any scripture. And I like to actually pick a scripture from the Psalms because they're already prayers.
Right.
They're already songs to God. And every emotion is in the Psalms. But you can't sing a wrong note. And if you just try it by yourself, get comfortable there, and you will. They will. You will get comfortable.
I remember when I first heard you teach this, you did a session on it. I loved it. I just got so excited about it. But it's true. Like, when you just step in and do it, you know, just step out by faith and just do it. Instead of reading your scriptures, sing your scriptures. It's like you can feel the breakthrough. Yeah. You can feel the different plane on which you're releasing from. And it's beautiful, and it can actually bring you into spiritual encounter as well.
Oh, absolutely. I just say, if you want to see heaven, sing about it. Sing Isaiah 6. Sing Revelation, 4 and 5. Sing Ezekiel 1 and the wheel. If you start singing it, because again, when you add that melody, the only thing your brain can actually process is what you're singing. And we know with the eyes of our heart, we can actually begin to see what we're singing with the eyes of our heart. I think God is a genius because he made it so easy that you don't even need training to sing one note and get breakthrough.
You know, children, they just naturally sing, don't they?
They do.
They just will belt it out, and they're not aware of if people like it or not. It doesn't really matter. They're not self-conscious. And I think the biggest hurdle to overcome is just getting through that first note and just going for it. But it is so powerful. And when we get back from our break right now, maybe we'll just do a little bit of that singing, but you're going to hear some testimonies that are awesome, that will excite you, because many of you, I think, are going to have breakthroughs even in your family salvations. You know, you can sing your family into salvation. Just get those scriptures all lined up and sing away and watch what God will do with your songs. I just want to encourage you, anytime in the program, just start singing away. Find a scripture and sing it away. Anyways, Julie, this is so awesome and so fun. And why don't you share a few testimonies? We have one from Eli that is a great testimony. And you also have one of Raymond as well.
Yes. Well, I met a friend, you've met her, Eli Rose. She was on the streets as a teenager and running with a very hard gang. Anyway, she was going to end her life. She comes to the healing rooms in Santa Maria, and Rick Taylor has a word of the Lord. Someone wants to end their life, don't. And she gave her life to the Lord. It's incredible testimony that actually she wrote for this book, because what she said is right after she gave her life to the Lord, she went into a treatment center. But one thing she started doing was rapping and singing the Bible.
Wow.
And she credits just her whole change of mindset because she was singing and rapping. She wanted to rap all 150 Psalms. And we connected right after I moved there, because I started talking about singing the scriptures.
Sure.
And she said, this is what I've
That's
done.
Awesome.
It's an amazing testimony. And then, so I started going down to her home. It's called Restoration Center. I started going down to her, it's a homeless shelter, because she reaches out. And we started doing music class. us. Oh, and wonderful. I don't preach to people. I don't even pray for them. We just say we're here for music. We do our stretches and me. And then our music classes, I have a sing CD that goes hand in hand with this. And it's just seven musical styles that you can put on and sing the Bible. And there's some fun ones. There's some fun, good beat ones. And I put this music on and I just say, okay, we're going to sing the word. I said, you can write a song, you can rap it, you can sing it, but we're just going to have a songwriting. And they just started writing. The first time I went, I saw this man in the back that would not look at anyone. He had his head down. And finally, I just saw him writing because I have a microphone. I go up to different people and we were doing Psalm 116 verses 1 and 2. And I still remember, I love the Lord. I love the Lord. I love the Lord because he listens. They got it. That God listens awesome. Because they rapped it. And this guy, within a 20 minute, not even 30 minutes, he came out of him. I saw him before my eyes. I saw drugs leave him. Wow. I mean, I saw him come alive. And he starts singing Psalm 116. And then all of a sudden, it's almost like the spirit of prophecy fell and he started going, you, and he started encouraging people. And I'm like, all we did was sing the Bible. Another time I went, Raymond, who is, he's also in our book. He comes in and he's playing with his phone the whole time. And I just do what, this time we're singing Psalm 23. And after a while, I see him kind of put his phone down. And I just go up to him with the mic. And I said, Raymond, do you have something that you'd like to sing? And I couldn't really understand him. Right. He was kind of mumbles. And I went up to him 3 or 4 times. And finally, about the fourth time, and this time I took a band with me. And the band was there to back mm-hmm. everyone. And he got up. And he looked at everyone and he goes, the Lord is my shepherd. I have everything I need. And the room went crazy. Wow. And what Eli told me later is that Raymond had lost everything. Wow. He had given his life over to drugs. He lost his family. He was a businessman. He lost everything. And all the progress he would lose because of, you know, drugs and just, but she said when he got up and sang that was the first time he actually looked at people. And she said it was the first time he didn't mumble. That was and you can hear them going crazy in the background. And I'm just going, I mean, I'm just like, this works. And they called me about a month and a half later and it was Eli and Raymond. And she goes, we're calling you because Raymond's going into treatment and he wants you to know
beautiful.
That. And I ask her, I always say, how's he doing? He's still doing good. And I feel what I have seen that in Ephesians 5:18-19, when Paul writes, do not be drunk with wine because that is foolishness, but be filled with the Spirit. And he says, sing, make music in your heart. But he said, sing psalms, hymns, and spiritual sounds. And what I feel I'm seeing is that singing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs are an antidote for addiction.
Wow, I
saw
that.
It right before my eye. And the key is they're still doing good.
I love it.
And one of the first guys that had this, you know, when I just saw him just sober up, just come to his mind. It was some months later, I was at our house of prayer and I was leading intercession and I saw this guy and it looked nice and I couldn't quit looking at him. And I was like, what is it? And I saw Eli come in and just kind of tap him and she mouths the words, this is James.
Wow.
And that was the guy
awesome.
You know, and I'm like, this is a powerful tool.
Powerful.
If medical science is using it for breakthrough in the mm-hmm. brains, Paul, this is just my interpretation. If you struggle with addiction, I encourage you to sing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs. And
so
I'm watching people get free that have given their lives to drugs. It was Eli's testimony, because they started rapping and singing the Bible. That's how powerful it is. So this notion of, I have to sound beautiful. No, you just have to have a sound.
And the
thing
about singing, it's from the heart. Mm-hmm. So it heals the soul as well.
It
when
does.
You sing, you can heal the soul. You can feel your soul being lifted when you sing, because, you know, it's birthed from the soul. I had a friend in elementary school who had a very severe stutter, so much so that he couldn't get a sentence together. And yet, when he sang, there was no stutter at all.
That Mel Tillis, a great country and western, he had a stutter. And when he sang, he didn't stutter. And Katie Souza also told me that she credits singing the word. That was a big part of her life, you know, when she met the Lord and just the healing of her soul.
Yeah.
So it is powerful. And my encouragement is, get that melody part out of your mind. It's not just, you know, start with a hum. Can you do that? Oh, see, I was going to say, see, anybody can go. And then just the words are already here.
Yeah.
We don't have to think of what
you don't
say
have
now.
To make up the lyrics.
You can stay right here. I love the Lord. You know, I just
you can have fun with it. You just have to get over the inhibitions, right? You just have to let it all out. I said earlier about Acts 16:31 that there's, you know, the Bible says that your house will be saved when you believe. Yeah. That's the truth. Mm-hmm. All of your family will be saved when you believe, if you believe that. And the thing is that when you sing, it makes it more believable to you.
Yeah.
The faith ignites, right?
I just feel like the words, they're going out. They can't return void. That song, it's also like that light.
Yeah.
And it goes out. I sing Psalm 1 over all my family that are not walking with God.
Right. It's so beautiful. Psalm 1, so that they meditate on the word day and night.
And the promise of being like a tree planted by streams of water, and everything you do is successful.
It's so beautiful.
Yeah.
What about children? Should this be taught in Sunday schools?
Oh, absolutely. I remember, this was another thing, I remember learning, you know, Zacchaeus was a wee little man. I learned that in like first grade.
Right.
But that's part of that emotional response.
Yeah.
When you sing, you remember way more than if you memorize.
And that's what they're finding with Alzheimer's patients, is that they'll have them sing, but a lot of their memory that they recall is songs that they learned when they were little.
Mm-hmm.
It triggers it too. So it's very, very powerful.
And I love the George Whitefield and John Wesley. They realized, the early revivalist part of the First Great Awakening, they realized that people could remember a song more than they could remember a sermon. Therefore, Charles started writing songs from John's sermons, and they wanted everyone to remember the Christmas story. And it was Charles Wesley with George Whitefield tweaking, "Hark the herald angels sing." And they were thinking, if we can just get him to sing the Christmas story, maybe this will last throughout the test of time. And we're still singing it. And almost every person can sing the first verse by memory.
Wow.
This is the power of putting melody. And that's what Paul said. Psalms, hymns, that's him.
And spiritual songs.
The spiritual songs are the songs that just pop up in the moment. Like, I love you, I love you.
And even praying in tongues.
Yeah.
You know, singing in tongues feels, even in your soul, more powerful than praying in tongues.
Yeah.
There's something about just lifting your voice up and letting your soul release those words. And it's a spiritual song. You don't know what you're saying.
Yeah.
You don't understand it, but you just know that it's good and things are happening. So, Now, Julie, we just have a minute left, but I want to share with our audience also about, you're a mentor for singing in the spirit, but also you're a voice coach, and you help people with worship leading and coach them through that. But you actually have an online tool that I'd love for you to share with our viewers about.
Yeah, we have an online worship community, and it's intotheriver.net. I have a closed Facebook page, and it's for anyone that even loves worship. And we talk about singing the scriptures. Right now, we're singing our way through the Psalms so that we actually take Psalms and it becomes ours, not just David's prayer. But I love encouraging people in this. And I feel like I know these people I've never met. And it's, I have monthly guests. Katie Sousa is going to be with us in 2 weeks, and people can just ask her questions. And but it's called intotheriver.net. It, my whole family's involved in it, and I love doing it.
Awesome. So Singing the Scriptures by Julie Meyer. You want to get this, and you can get it on Amazon right now, or you can go to Julie's website. But this will be a great tool and something that you can share with your friends as well. Get a couple copies so that your friends can learn to sing the scriptures and have their life transformed. I want to minister to someone who's watching this program right now that you have so much shame on you for singing. Because when you were young and you sang, people made fun of you. And as you stepped out even later after you had some classes in school, again, you were mocked for singing. And it's in you. The song is in you and the voice is in you. But you have felt so hindered because of the shame. But right now, Jesus is lifting that garment of shame off of you. And he's saying, I've heard every note that you ever sung. I've heard every expression of your heart before me, and I love it. And I think that you're amazing, and you're one of the most outstanding voices in heaven. That's what he's saying to you. And he's saying, just before him, take up the scriptures and begin to sing them, because it's going to make such an impact on your life and give you so much release. I want to say thank you to all of you for joining us on today's program today. And God wants you to remember this, that he loves you with an everlasting love. He really, really does. So go and share that love with someone, you know, around you and the world that you live in this week. God bless. See you next time.
You have gifts. God expects you to use them. If you need training to school your gift, log on to schoolofthespirit.tv. You'll find training in spiritual warfare, prophetic ministry, prayer, seer's ministry, writing, and so much more. Go to schoolofthespirit.tv today. You want to go deeper? Get equipped to overcome and walk in God's purpose for your life at Awakening House of Prayer's online campus. You'll experience an online family, preaching, teaching, and prophetic impartation for victorious living. We have over 1,000 members online, hungry for what God is saying and doing in the earth. Visit ahop.online today and join our family.
This has been a production of the Awakening Podcast Network. Jennifer LeClaire is the founder and owner of APN. Our heart is to inspire people and exalt Jesus with every broadcast. We're grateful for our advertisers and supporters that make these podcasts possible.